lovely face.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to St. Thomas Church. How lovely to see you today. So, in your program, there's a whole write-up on Dobby Day and all this, stuff, but I know what you really want to know. How did he get to come to Columbus, Georgia and St. Thomas? Am I right?
Yes.
Yes, of course. So, Hunter Mullen, who sings in our choir, studied opera this summer in Italy, and he became friends with Davide and his family and stayed a few extra weeks. Then Hunter says to me, "Oh, Rick, I have a friend who's a fantastic pianist. Could he do a recital at the church?" I said, "Can he play?" I mean, we have standards to hold up, right? Well, I'm never going to play this piano again after I heard him. I kid you not, he played Claire de Lune this morning. My phone blew up with live streamers. Who is that? Who? And oh my goodness. So, Hunter, thank you for bringing him here, creating those international relationships. And in this beautiful, intimate space with our Max Burr Memorial Piano. And we're just so happy that you're here. Just relax. I think Davide is going to do program notes verbally. Okay. Are we ready to bring him on?
Yes.
Let's see if we can get him on.
Such a big audience. Thank you very much for coming and enjoy this musical moment with me. And I want to thank in particular Rick, Chris Grace and Hunter for making this concert possible. I'm glad that they worked for me so hard and I'm so glad to be here today. So the title of this concert is A Journey with the Piano, because the program I chose is a program that goes through different styles of piano literature. I'm going to start with the classical period, with Mozart, and I will move to the romantic period, the modern period, and also I'm going to play a piece of a contemporary American composer, Philip Glass. And the first piece I'm going to play today is the first movement of the A minor piano sonata by Mozart. This sonata was composed in 1778, when Mozart was traveling around Europe. He was in Paris in that period, and the atmosphere of this sonata is very turbulent, because in that period of his life, Mozart's mom died. So that was a very intense moment for him, and you can hear all the intensity of that struggling, of that sufferance in this first movement of the sonata. Enjoy the Mozart.
Thank you.
second piece of the program is an impromptu by Franz Schubert. Impromptu means improvisation. Schubert used to play in the Salon in Vienna. He was contemporary to Beethoven, but he was not as famous as Beethoven was. So he used to play at his friend's house and to improvise at the piano these beautiful, beautiful melodies. And at some point, he published these melodies in a collection called Impromptus. There are two collections of Impromptus. And this first impromptu that I'm going to play is the third impromptu of the opus number 90. It's a wonderful music. Schubert's music is can be described with the figure of the traveler. It's like a travel, a journey. It's a music that really needs to be listened and followed and just be transported by the music without thinking too much, because music speaks by itself. Schubert's music speaks by itself. So this is impromptu number 3.
Thank you.
For the next piece I'm going to play, I have the pleasure to play with this beautiful singer, Rachel, who is going to perform with me this wonderful lied by Schumann. It's called Big Moon. It's one of the most beautiful, beautiful lieder in music history. So enjoy this wonderful romantic piece. The first one is a short etude, it's called the Aeolian Harp Etude. This name derives from a writing made by Schumann talking about this collection of etudes written by Chopin. And it's a beautiful short piece with this wonderful melody accompanied by a very fast and smooth arpeggio part in the internal section of the piano. The second piece is called J'adore la Villa d'Este. It's a piece from the collection Année de Pèlerinage by Franz Liszt. This is a collection that Liszt wrote while he was traveling through Europe. So there are many books in this collection, and every book is about one country. There is one about Italy, one about Switzerland, and this beautiful piece, J'adore la Villa d'Este, is in the book from Italy, because he wrote this piece of music, this wonderful piece of music, when he was in Tivoli, which is a small town close to Rome, and there is a wonderful villa, this Villa d'Este, it's a real place, and it's famous because in this villa there are a lot of fountains with a lot of water games, and these water games inspired Liszt to compose this beautiful piece, J'adore à la Villa d'Este, which means water games at Villa d'Este. So, Chopin first and Liszt after.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. I never could learn to read music, and then maybe it wouldn't let me stop.
Really?
What I wanted to do was play softball and basketball and football. And it wouldn't let me stop. The piano. I mean, I wish they had all that money. Slowest time ever recorded. I had a girlfriend that, a couple of years. They were not there on Wednesday. Well, it made it easier.
Friends, again, thanks for coming. Now we're going to have the second half of the program. Should you be moved, there's an offering plate back there. Davida is about to begin a doctoral program in piano performance in Italy, so I'm sure that anything you could do would be helpful. He wanted to do it and give it the trip the choir's going to make to Italy in 2024. I said, oh, don't be silly. Let's just do this, because I don't know any rich pianists, do you? No, not. So, unfortunately, it's just check or cash. But anyway, thank you all so much for coming. And is he ready? Let's welcome our artist.
This piece was composed in 1979 in the occasion of a speech of the Dalai Lama in the northern in North America. So Philip Glass composed this piece to entertain the audience waiting for the Dalai Lama to speak. So it's a beautiful music. Minimalist music is based on repetition, and it's beautiful because it gives the performer the opportunity to play with all the beautiful colors and different timbres that is possible to produce with these instruments. So I suggest you to relax and to try to enjoy the different colors that I will try to produce with this wonderful piano.
Thank you.
The next two pieces of my program are two preludes by the composer, the French composer Claude Debussy. The first prelude is entitled The Girl with the Flaxen Hair and is inspired by a beautiful poem that talks about this girl that sits on a grass outdoor and is singing on this grass in the morning. The second prelude is The Sunken Cathedral, and it's inspired by a Breton legend that talks about this city, this town called Is, who was sunken by the sea because of the sins of its inhabitants. And the cathedral of this town reemerged from the water every morning as a warning for all the inhabitants of the coast. So you will hear in this music the beginning with a very soft and like cloudy mood, and at a certain point you will hear this beautiful sound that keeps growing and growing and growing until the cathedral reemerged from the water, and in the second part of the piece the cathedral goes down again into the sea. So I'm going to play first The Girl with the Flaxen Hair and second The Sunken Cathedral by Debussy.
Thank you.
last two pieces of the program are from the composer Sergei Rachmaninoff, a Russian composer who moved to America at some point of his life. Rachmaninoff for many years was considered as a minor composer, but as you can listen, his music really speaks to the soul of people. So I don't want to add anything. I'm going to play two pieces by Rachmaninoff. The first piece is an Etude Tableau, Opus 33, number two, in C major, and the second one is the prelude in B minor. So enjoy these two last pieces of the concert.
Thank you.
I hope this is the first of a long series. Thank you.
I think you need to move here.
Good idea.
Of course, I came with no money.